I have a book on how to write, but it was written by someone who was not a natural writer. And that's a good thing, but he had to figure out how to do it. It's like trying to learn the piano from someone who plays by ear. They say, well, you just sit down and do it. So learning the way to share the gospel is probably better learned from somebody who actually doesn't know how to do it. And that's why I qualify, because I'm not naturally an evangelist. You know, in 1 Peter 2:9, this was a huge verse to me. It was very helpful in my process of beginning to share the gospel. 1 Peter 2:9 says, you're a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, his own special people, that you may proclaim the praises. And that word is the excellencies of the one who's called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. So I began to think this way. Okay, you've probably heard my story before. I was a chicken. I was afraid to talk to people. And I just felt guilty and frustrated. And one night I got down by my bed and I said, Lord, I'm a chicken. You know I'm a chicken. I know I'm a chicken. There's no use kidding about that. I'm not confrontational. I'm afraid to offend people. This isn't good. I want to be used by you. So if you can use chickens, I'm available. And I began to pray and ask the Lord to change my heart. And this verse was hugely helpful to me, because what I realized was Christ and the gospel had excellencies. And the word excellent, of course, is used now as a comparative rather than a superlative. So a whole parking lot of excellent cars. Well, that's an improper use of the word, because excellent means it excels all the others. There can only be one car out of all of them that's excellent, that excels all the others. So I began to think that way. And some of you have heard my little talk on the uniqueness of Christianity. That comes out of this verse. The things that you can only find in Jesus, the things that you can only find in the gospel. And so I prayed and said, Lord, when I go out into the day, I want to be thinking about one of these excellencies. What's so great about being a Christian? What's so great about Jesus? And if that was in my mind, then I'd say, now, Lord, please bring me into contact with someone who needs to hear this, who's open to hear this. And if you don't mind, let me have this opportunity by them bringing up the conversation. Now, it may seem like a crazy prayer, but I'll tell you something. Probably for 3 or 4 years, I never initiated a conversation about the gospel. But every time I prayed that prayer and I went out into the day saying, Lord, I'm really enjoying this idea about Jesus or about the gospel, I want to share it with someone, he would actually do that. And I can tell you lots of stories, amazing stories, about people who would ask me something that would trigger the opportunity for the gospel. So that's a tremendous thing, to move from this feeling of guilt and obligation to this joy and thankfulness and gratefulness and thinking about the excellencies of the gospel and why it's so great to be saved, to pass that on.